The town of Jaro is known for being called the mestizo town of Iloilo. Jaro is the largest of all the seven districts comprising the city of Iloilo. Its original name was Salog or Saro. Jaro officially became a city in 1891. It had been one of the richer areas of Iloilo City, even during the Spanish colonial period, and probably the richest town of the entire colony. Historical artifacts indicate that it had once conducted trade with China and Siam due to its port along the navigable river that ran through the town. It was also the center of religious and economic power in the Visayas during the Spanish rule. At present, Jaro, which holds the distinction as being the largest by land area of all the seven districts of Iloilo City. Also is the most populous. Jaro has produced or is associated with people who became prominent and distinguished in their fields of services. Graciano Lopez Haina was a Filipino journalist, orator, reformist, and national hero who is well known for his newspaper, La Solidaridad. Graciano Lopez Haina was born in Jaro, Iloilo, in the Captaincy General of the Philippines in the Spanish Empire on December 18, 1856. In his honor, the Jaro Plaza was renamed the Graciano Lopez Haina Park, where there is also a statue of him. Patrocinio Gamboa y Villarreal was a Filipino revolutionary notable for her participation in the Philippine Revolution. Patrocinio Gamboa was born on April 30, 1865 in Jaro, Iloilo. Gamboa was an avid reader of Spanish classics and newspapers. She was also deeply influenced by the literary works of the propaganda movement. In her honor, a marker was installed in Jaro, Iloilo on December 21, 1980. Associated Jareños are the towns of people who are not citizens by birth or who stayed in Jaro either as professors, staff, or studied in its academic institutions, took a residence for a short or long period of time in the district, and other factors. Here are a few of the notable Jareños. Raul Maravilla Gonzalez, Fernando Felenia Lopez Sr., Magdalena Halandoni, Miriam Defensor Santiago, Francis Hardeleza, Manuel Araneta Jr. Jaro is located between Dungon Creek and the Jaro River. The district of Jaro fulfills the ideal design for establishing communities during that era. Many Ilonggos are selling candles in front of the Jaro Metropolitan Cathedral. The church is the famous parish of Our Lady of Candles, also known as the Jaro Metropolitan Cathedral. The headquarters of the Archdiocese of Jaro and the site of a miraculous statue of the Virgin Mary, which was canonically crowned by the late Pope John Paul II during his visit in 1982. Spanish culture is heavily imprinted in Jaro's way of life. The celebrations of patronal fiestas, language, people, education, and cuisine. Museums are repositories of Jaroenos, or Ilonggos as a whole. Way of life during pre-colonial, colonial, and post-colonial and modern periods. A plethora of art galleries and museums showcasing exhibits of fossils and historical artifacts, and artworks from both local and international artists are found in Jaro. As Jaro is the seat of Roman Catholicism in Western Visayas, some of its festivals are religious celebrated. The Fiesta de Nuestra Señora de la Candelaria, or Feast of Our Lady of the Candles, commonly known as Fiesta de Jaro, held every February 2, is one of the largest known religious feasts in honor of Virgin Mary in the Philippines. It is a celebration in honor of Western Visayas' official Roman Catholic patron, Nuestra Señora de la Candelaria. It was brought by the Spaniards, where it is also widely venerated in the Canary Islands as Virgin of Candelaria.